Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to do an example of a hypothesis test problem using a proportion. So Sylvia bought a seed pack that promised to yield 27% pink flowers. When the flowers bloomed, she painstakingly counted all of them and found 433 blue flowers and 138 pink flowers. Using a significance level of 0.05, test the claim on the seed pack. First of all, you need to determine what your claim is and write it in symbols. So the claim here is that 27% of the flowers will be pink. And that means that we're using an equality in our claim. And so that means that our claim is our null hypothesis. Since our null hypothesis is equal to, then the alternative hypothesis is not equal to. And every time we have not equals to, we have a two-tailed test. The next thing we have to do is find our test statistic, and that was from an earlier video. I had those listed, so I wrote it here. We need p hat. Well, p hat is actually here it is over here. I was going to say, where did I show that? P hat is x over n. That's the number of successes, basically the number of pink flowers over the total number. So we had 138 pink flowers. And if you add 433 and 138 together, we had 571 flowers altogether. And so if I divide that, I get 0.241681. Now the reason I'm going out so far here is depending on what program you're using. Sometimes you can have round off errors where your number doesn't quite match because you rounded off. And so when in doubt, don't round it off. Okay, and then the P was the given proportion that was 27% or 0.27. Q is just 1 minus 0.27, which is 0.73. The N we already said was 571 and the X was 138. So I just took all those values and put them into that formula and I got a test statistic of negative 1.52. So really, when I'm doing a test statistic with two tails, I'm looking at the negative and positive of that because it's a two-tailed test. But my test statistic is just the one on the left, which is fine. I want to find the area to the left of negative 1.52. Now, you're going to use technology, whether it's your calculator or StatCrunch or some program online. For the TI-36X Pro, I have a video on how to find the area under the curve given a z-score, which is what we're doing here. And these are the steps: second function data, distribution, normal CDF, your mean is 0, sigma 1, lower bound, and upper bound. And then you get this value of 0.06426. But that's just the area on the left side. So if we look at this picture, because I told you we were going to have a two-tailed test, we have 0.06426 on the left. We have the same amount on the right. So the p-value is in the area in the two red regions because we're looking at a two-tailed test. The red regions are on either end here. All right, so the p-value equals 0.06426 times 2, which is 0.1285. Now we're supposed to compare that to the significance level we were given, which was 0.05. And we can see that 1.1285 is greater than 0.05. Since the p-value was high, the null will fly, and we will fail to reject the null. Remember, in this problem, the claim was the null hypothesis because it had an equation part in it, so an equality part. So we just failed to reject it. Since we failed to reject it, we cannot find fault with the supposition that the pack of seeds contains 27% pink flowers. Another way to say that is there is not sufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the claim that 27% of the flowers will be pink. I have no idea why that word's not bold. This is the way it would say there's not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection, because with the null hypothesis, we either reject or we failed to reject. So in our final conclusion, we don't say we support or we don't support, or we like it or we don't like it. We say there's not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection. All right. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.